Hey guys, MechanicCG here, and welcome back to Forza Motorsport 4. Today is episode number 40. If you guys are enjoying the content, then be sure to leave a like, comment down below, subscribe, and feel free to hit that join button as it really does help support the channel. Hopefully you guys enjoy. This episode was streamed live on YouTube. If you want to make sure to catch the streams, then be sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell. If you want to get cheap game keys for Xbox, PlayStation or PC, then check out Enaba in the description down below. Right, so we are here now for the Class A North American Tour. We're going to be starting off in the Ford GT, going around Indianapolis, Road Atlanta, Infinium Raceway, Mazda Raceway and then Sebring. All right, here we go. Let's do this. Oi! It's time for the Ford GT around the Indianapolis Raceway. Oh my gosh, this thing's... Bloody hell, this has got an engine and a half. Oh, I missed my braking point. I completely missed that. One thing I will say, I think music needs to be turned down a tad. There we go. Oh! Good start so far. Lambo or Porsche? I don't know. I'd probably still say Lambo over Porsche. Only because of the fact Porsche is... It's a nice brand. If it was a 918, I'd take the Porsche 918. I'd take the Porsche 918 any day of the week over any Lamborghini. Any other Porsche gets beaten by every Lamborghini. 100%. The 918 I would have. Other than that, nah. I'll pass. Yeah. I think the 918 is one of those cars that's just like... Wow. The SVJ doesn't cut it for me. It's not anything wow compared to an Aventador. So it doesn't feel that insane. It's really weird. It's really weird. Whereas the Porsche 918, you look at that and you're like, holy shit, that's a Porsche. Wow. It's a little more impressive than, say, the SVJ. Oh, I missed my braking point again. Uh-oh. Like Zoink Scoob. Uh. 175, that's pretty much close to the fastest we've been yet. Damn, this is one hell of an engine. Ooh. Lambo McLaren. Ooh. again for that. It's very much depending on what. It very much depends on what car. If it was a Senna, I'd probably say yeah. I'd probably say McLaren. Whoa! I have no clue what happened with that. I'm having slight network issues with Tidal. I think Tidal's gone down. We got no music. Rest in pepperonis. Holy crap. Again, can sleep, but have a great gaming session, even better stream. Blow up trust in the process. I appreciate it, man. I appreciate it. Thank you so much for sticking around, man. Have yourself a good day. Hopefully, we get to see you again soon. I need to figure out what on earth has happened to this music, because it's gone on strike. Holiday time for the music, but the music didn't ask for a holiday pay. All right, here we go. It's time to work it. This is what we do. Beep beep, motherfucker, get out of the way! Tap the rear of the car in front. Not the best idea, but... Holy crap! Oh my gosh. Absolutely pinned it. Look at the damage on the front of the car, though. When you get a little bit of damage, it absolutely destroys this. Nice. Whoa. you know you never know. Come on, we got this. 161. Not bad. Not too bad. I need the caffeine to kick in, so I can stay awake for at least a couple hours. Because once I finish this, I'm laying down and going to sleep. One, 161 again. Yeah, this is actually one of the better interiors to drive in. Both to drive in and sort of experience in Forza. I don't know what it is. Welcome to the guilty party. I might just do this one episode today. Whoa! We've hit the wall. The wall of shame. Alright, here we go. Infineon Raceway. Beep beep, motherfucker, get out the way. Whoa! Watch it, Sonny Jim! Not bad. Oh, never mind. Bad, bad, bad. It's actually quite a good layout, this one, because it takes you across this section of the track instead. Obviously, slows you down a little bit. And especially with this section, it makes the final two corners a lot easier to do. Not bad. Didn't see it coming. Not bad. Couple more corners to go. accidentally went into reverse there. Let's keep it going, keep it going. Get across the finish line. Way. Very nice. I'll take that. Good old bit of Muse to uplift the beat and... I don't know. And we're off. It's time to drive this car. So come on. I got an email. Yay! Oh, it's someone trying to pretend to be Apple. Do they not know that I don't have an Apple ID anymore and that I haven't had an iPhone for 6+ years? Probably not. Isn't what I hate about these scam emails, like, is not even the fact that it's believable. It's fucking stupid. Come on! So tired. Today's been a long day. So. hand you in. All right, not bad. Bad. I'll take that. Lovely job, Blair.
Alright! There we go, it's time to drive!
So I was having issues getting the, what's it called? The super chat. The channel membership thing to work. For the member-a-thon thing that I'm going to be doing on the 22nd. Hopefully... it was just a one-off. There's an easy way that I can adjust the timer anyways. But obviously it would be preferable if the timer actually worked when it works, so.
It's time to drive, mate. Way.
So yeah, hopefully the member-a-thon actually works properly when it comes to the stream. Otherwise, I might have to cry internally. Which could quite quickly turn into external crying.
What?
Yeah, cry externally as well. Well, it's quite nice to drive, actually. Apology video. I apologize for my crying on stream. Unfortunately, it all went horribly wrong. What they call a content as of nowadays. Yes, apology videos is like 50% of YouTube now. I'm sorry for the way that I behaved. It was wrong of me. I should not do it. I saw on, what was it, Twitter, there was a Top Gear letter of complaint. Which was actually kind of funny. And it just looked like... It was just like a template for any complaint letter. I'm sorry for apologizing in this video. It turns out my apology was not needed. It's kind of crazy the performance increase that we've just had from like B class to A class. We are slowly turning into Canadians. The world is becoming Canada. That's what it is. Ta-da! Let's do another one! Ow. Way, Heinz won! Woo-hoo. I've set it so that repeat rewards won't happen, but it probably means, yeah, that will happen. But I can just go through here and I'll give you the last car. Ah! It's all wibbly wobbly. There you go. Absolutely dreadful drive, but who cares? I'll use the excuse, I'm used to dirt rally now. So you should have all the exclusive cars for this month now. Mine. Which is epic! Way, McLaren P1! Whoop, whoop. Zeno is going to be a little bit jealous that he can't get the P1 yet. It's the part where that's my problem. Oh, that's great. Sorry, whose problem's that? Not mine. And there we go, that's that one done. And now we've actually completed the championship. Way. I got Ford Enthusiast, so I assume I'm on good books with Ford. So thank you guys so much for watching. If you did enjoy, be sure to leave a like, comment down below and subscribe, and I will see you in the next one. Peace out.